Welcome to clickmyproject.com.
Now we are going to discuss about the product life-threatening ventricular arrhythmia detection with personalized features. Now we are going to discuss about the abstract for the process. Electrocardiogram, that is the ECG, is the most important and widely used method to study the diseases related to heart. The detailed study of ECG graph helps the medical practitioner to diagnose the condition of the heart. Based on the information provided by the ECG graph, an appropriate treatment can be given to the patient. The patient with the medical history of heart alignment should maintain a record of ECG papers for timely analysis and diagnosis of the diseases, which requires large storage space and extensive manual effort. The visual technique of analyzing the ECG signal is tedious and time-consuming. Hence, to overcome this problem, an automatic system which involves digital signal integration and analysis tool is developed using the MATLAB. Hence, this is well efficient to classify whether the signal is affected by the arrhythmia or not. This is very time low conceptual, and hence this is more reliability than the other conventional method. Now we are going to discuss about the flow diagram for the process. This is the overall flow structure for the process. Hence the flow consists of the major 5 steps. First one is the data acquisition. Second one is the data pre-processing. Third one is the feature extraction. Fourth one is the classification. At last, the final one is the performance estimation. At first, the data, which is the ECG signal, which is taken from the dataset folder. The dataset is the folder which consists of the several signals. After getting any one signal from the dataset, the data pre-processing is carried out. In this data pre-processing steps, we have the two steps. First one is the average filter, then the second one is the high pass filter. Here the average filter is considered as a low pass filter, and then after applying this low pass filter, we have to apply the high pass filter by using the Butterworth filter. After applying these two filtering, we have to extract the feature from the signal. For the feature extraction, we done the two steps. First one is the QRS detection, then the second one is the RR interval. This QRL detection, so QRL detection is based on this figure. After the QRS detection, the RR interval is carried out to extract the intervals between the R peak and the R peak. After getting these two values, those are saved as a test feature. After the feature extraction steps, the classification is done by using the SVM classification. In this SVM classifier, we have to give the three things as an input. First one is the test feature, then train feature, at last the target. The test feature represents the feature of the input signal, then the train feature represents the feature of the whole dataset signals. After these two features, the targeted is given as an input. The target is nothing but the whether the input is normal or abnormal. So here we have the two targets. First one is 1 and 2. After the SVM classification, the performance is estimated by using the parameters like accuracy, sensitivity, specificity, F-score, precision, and MCC. So these are the parameters to justify whether the process is efficient or not. Now we are going to discuss about the initial running procedure for the process. At first, open the MATLAB 2013 and change the current directory. If you want to execute the code, means just right click in the mainfile.m and select the option run. Now the dataset folder was open. In the dataset folder, you can see the several signals. Select any one signal from the dataset folder. After the selection of the signal, click the button open. Now the process will done automatically. Now the overall process was finished. Now we can discuss the process one by one. Now this is the figure 1, which represents the input signal which we have selected from the data set. Now this is the ECG signal in the range of the 0 to 1000. After the input signal selected from the data set, the image signal smoothing is done. In the sigma smoothing, this figure represents the subplot of the input signal, random signal, noisy added signal, then at last the final smoothed signal. The input signal is consist of the signal which we have taken as an input. The random signal is generated based on the random values of the input signal. Then the third one represents the noisy added signal which the random values are added to the input signal. Then the smoothed signal is the final filtered signal or the smoothed signal. Now figure 3 represents the filtered by the another filtering method. Now the filtered signal is shown in the figure 3 with the title filtered signal. After the filtering process, that is the pre-processing is completed, we have to estimate the parameters like minimum interval, maximum interval, then the heart rate. The minimum interval is 138, then the maximum interval is 361, then the heart rate is 30. After the estimation of these three parameters, we have to deduct the Q or S wave from the signal. Hence, the Q is represented as a red color, then the T is represented as a green color, and the P is represented as a black color. Now, the raw signal is plotted in the blue color, those which we have filtered from the input signal. After the QRS deduction, the feature extraction is done. The feature extraction is nothing but the collection of the data from the signal. After the collection of the data, those are plotted as a test feature. After the test feature extraction, the train feature is shown in the table 6. Here, the feature values of the dataset signals are shown in the table 6. After that, the classification is done by using the SVM classification method. Hence, the SVM classification shows whether the input signal is normal or abnormal. Here, the input signal is abnormal. Hence, the message box will be displayed as an abnormal signal. After that, at last, the performance is estimated. Now, the performance is plotted in the bar chart format, as well as those values are shown in the reading box. Now the accuracy is 96%, error rate is 4%, sensitivity 92.8%, specificity 100%, precision 100%, F1 score 96.2%, MCC 92.2%. Those values are plotted in the bar chart format as well as in the line chart format.
Thanks for watching this video.